Hello guys, welcome back to the ORS Smugglers. My name is Siggi, and with me today is Bjarni. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Yep, I am excellent. So, this is obviously not a bottle report.
What's going on? What?
Today we're gonna have a short bonus video.
Ooh.
We are painting, or I am painting, four new tables for the local game store. And I'm using an airbrush. We're painting it on a 4x4 board, and then we will have a 3x3 play area with some borders.
Okay.
And here I'm just using stencils to try to make a nebula. And I'm not going to bother you too much with talk. So.
Are these stencils that you made yourself?
Yep. Yeah. I say yes, but my wife does it. Yeah. Here I'm just softening the edges. There are some hard edges from the stencils, and this is the first step. It's only white, and later in the video I will paint in the white, and I am essentially I am right now deciding the opacity of the colors that I will later paint in. So, where it's dark gray, there will be low opacity, and higher.
Yeah,
higher where the whites are.
And then you put colors in this at a later point.
Yeah. And here I've started with that. I'm putting in three colors here. This is the first one. And it's a light blue.
Yeah.
Sky blue kind of.
I see you're using the Iwata Eclipse.
Yeah, this is my main brush, and I've also got a good Iwata compressor, and it's a real pleasure to work with toys that are of such quality.
Most people familiar with airbrushing recognize this brush.
So we're on to the next color. It's a dark shade of blue, and in the first part where I had light blue, I didn't spray all the white areas because I knew the second color would come in, and then this time again, I'm not doing all of them because. A purple color will be the last color that I will add in.
Okay. The colors you're using?
I use Vallejo colors, airbrush colors. So here's the purple coming in, and it's starting to look like some sort of nebula.
Yeah. So where do you get your inspiration from? Do you gaze at the stars at night and think what's going on, or do you just wing it?
This is just winging it, but YouTube helps a lot. YouTube videos for tutorials, and then of course Google's just, and the Hubble telescope. Here I'm gonna paint some of the larger stars in the nebula, and these are I paint them blue at first and then white, so the hope is that I will get a blue glow around the stars.
Nice.
And some flare, of course.
Ooh.
And the stencils really help. It's not rocket science to paint a board like this. It's if you know how to use airbrush, it's no problem. Here I'm gonna splatter some stars on. I starve the airbrush of air, and then I pump some paint into it, and And then air comes on and it splatters.
Spit it out.
And it's worth to note that this can only be done with a gravity fed airbrush. Here I've laid a 3x3 board onto the board I painted, and I'm masking out the play area. I'm essentially creating borders, and here we see one of the boards.
Very nice.
And this is decorating the boards, and stencils are cut out by myself and my wife. The extra pairs there are hers.
Yeah, so you don't have four?
No, only two.
Only two.
So there it is. May the force be with you.
Very nice. Nice flavor to put some lines from the movies.
Yeah. The game store wanted a 4x4, and I thought with the borders, they had to have some decorations. So quotes and crowds from the and persons from the films.
I must just point this out. I've seen all the stencils you guys made, and you and your wife must have spent hours, if not days, making these stencils.
Yeah, these are. Not the hardest to cut out, but my wife is very artistic, and she can do these things, and so when you're a gamer, it pays to be well married.
That's my favorite little character.
Yep, you used this one to good effect on a couple of occasions.
Yeah. Made my opponent fly off the table last game.
was he frustrated?
He foresaw that he was not going to get a single hit on my ship for the rest of the game, so he just ended it by exiting gracefully.
And this is probably one of the more complex stances, but you have to have Vader.
Of course. You have to. And again, I must just say the stencil work is superb.
Yeah, thanks, Piani.
Now we get to see the results.
I was quite excited by this one, but it turns out really good.
Dum dum da dum dum da dum. There we go.
So this is the last part of the video, and here we are at Nexus, our local game store, and this is game night, and we are just taking a look at the boards with some people playing on them, and the footage will continue for a while, so we will say goodbye. Bye, Bjorn. Thanks for the commentary.
Oh, thank you for making these incredibly nice tables.
Yep. And I will see you in the next episode.
See.
Bye-bye.